Be bold and take action.
Do what you can with what you have where you are. Hello and welcome back to my channel. My name is Alexandra Emma. The purpose of this channel is to spread more love, positivity, and kindness into the world, and to also talk about spiritual topics, which if you ask someone like me, I think spirituality relates to everything in life, but go ahead and form your own opinion because I'm not trying to tell you to believe the same things as me. I'm just storytelling over here. So I wanted to talk a little bit today about the quote I just mentioned alongside being bold. So let's say that quote again. Do what you can with what you have where you are. So a lot of times with life, I think we can fall into the habit of waiting for the next big thing to happen to us, for an opportunity to just pop up, but a lot of times it is up to you to take action, to be bold, to start pursuing your dreams, to make things happen. And I will give a personal account, which you can see clearly from watching this channel. I'm being bold by doing this. This isn't something that was part of my normal routine. I felt guided to start a YouTube channel and to at least start getting some word out there about some of the things that I've been researching over the last year and to share some of my personal experience. Before books were developed and we started writing newspapers, before we had radio shows, most of information was passed on by word of mouth through storytelling. People knew how to get water from the river because it was a story passed on from the people, their elders. So, you know, that's what life is, just trying to pass on stories. And mine is just the fact that you should attempt to be bold and attempt to follow your dreams, but that does require effort and action on your part. It is such a good thing to dream big. I am a strong believer that if you, you know, shoot for the moon, you will land among the stars, and any one of those options would be wonderful and fantastic, that you should always dream big, because in some cases, you might get something that is just as good, if not better, which is why I go for things so hardcore. For example, when I was a sophomore in college, typically accounting internships were not given out to sophomores at that age level, but I told myself I had nothing to lose. I went for the interview and I landed the opportunity. That was an example of me being bold and taking the steps necessary to accomplish what I've always wanted to do. Let me dive a little bit deeper into that story. So I didn't just go in all willy-nilly thinking like, oh, this is mine. I went in with the mindset that anything I put my mind to, I can get, but it also requires hard work and determination. So prior to that interview process, I did a lot of research on the company itself. I did a lot of internal research on myself. I figured out what my positive character traits were, where I excelled. I even took account of the areas that I need work in, which, you know, if you go to any interview, a lot of times they'll say, all right, what are you great at? What are you not so great at? And you have to be able to formulate a response that still makes sure you do well in the interview, but is also honest and sincere. So I remember one big pitch of mine when I go to interviews is when they ask me, okay, well, what's your, you know, vulnerability? What's your negative character trait? I tell them I'm a very busy bee. Sometimes I get very caught up in my schedule. I like to take on too much. And as a result, sometimes I feel tired. And that was a very honest answer, but it also showed my employers that I am very active and looking forward to trying new things, starting new projects. So I had to do a lot of internal research on myself. I looked up the person I was interviewing with. I looked up about the profession. I was only a sophomore in accounting, so I still wasn't too familiar with the accounting world. At the time, it was what is private versus public accounting. You know, which field do I want to go into? Do I prefer tax? Do I prefer audit? What kind of person I am? How do I work? These were all things I had to research and look at beforehand. And alongside that, I performed in 2 mock interviews. And in both those interviews, I received pointers on my interview process. That way I could improve and hopefully be my best version going to my real interview. I remember at my first interview, mock interview, I should say, one of the biggest points that I needed to work on was the fact that I had all my long-term goals listed out, but I struggled to tell them about my short-term goals. So I made it a point to figure out, okay, what's my 10-year plan? What's my 5-year plan? What's my 3-month plan? What's my tomorrow plan? And be very honest and open with that. And when I got to the real interview, I was able to say, okay, well, I want to get, you know, A's in these classes next semester. And then eventually down the road, I plan to sit for the CPA exam. I hope to start at a public accounting firm. And then 10 years down the road, hopefully own my own business. This is all stuff that I had to plan out and think. And I even told my interviewer that I'm only guaranteed today, so I could have a plan out for 20 years down the road, and I can't promise you that I'll make it there, but I could hopefully plan, God willing. So that's just an example of a small thing, just interviewing for an internship, but I had to put so much hard work and time into this to see the plan take off and succeed. And there was also such a high chance that this opportunity would not take off and it would decline and fall. But I was willing to take the risk. And so part of being bold and being prepared is being willing to take the risk knowing that you could fail. Something I learned in one of my classes at Albright College, self-awareness, is the fact that if you don't take risk, you're gonna miss out on so many opportunities where you could succeed. You could do this good when really maybe you could do this good if you took a lot more risks. Sure, you're gonna fall. Sure, you're gonna fail. But that's part of the life process. It's part of the learning, getting back up, dusting your knees off, and saying, I'm ready to try again. You know, there's always like 1,000 ways something could end up not working, and then there's one way where it does, and that's what you gotta focus on, working towards that moment. I'm sure half of the technology that was developed today would not have been developed without trial and error. Trial and error is so necessary and so important. So again, I'm gonna repeat to you, do what you can with what you have where you are. Another person that says a quote that I really like, his name is Victor Odo. You can find him on YouTube. I'll actually link his channel down below because I love watching his videos. But he said one time, you must take imperfect action every day. What else can you ask for? You know, you can't essentially depend on the future to be there, but you can depend on the now, and you can depend on the fact that if you take imperfect action, you will get to your goals and your dreams. You have to do what you can now. And that means, you know, maybe one day I realize I have to study for the CPA exam for a couple hours, and I want to also read my book, film a YouTube video, and spend time with family. There are going to be days where I won't be able to juggle it all, but I'm going to make imperfect action every day. Maybe that day I study an hour less than I was planning to, or whatever. As long as I still take action and I don't sit in the background of my life, sit on the sidelines, that's all that matters. Because you know what? Silly as it is to say, we are the pilots, the drivers of our own life, and we have to take action. I do strongly believe that whatever is meant to be yours won't pass you by. Also meaning that opportunities will continue to present themselves to you throughout your life. Nothing is going to pass you by. But part of that is being willing to take action. And that is a strong belief of mine, being bold, taking action, being determined, ambitious, having goals, dreaming big. It's a very crazy out there idea, but for me, as a very upfront, confident person, and I wouldn't describe myself as confident, but I do realize when it comes to my career, I have a very authentic, forward way of believing that I can do anything. So I really want to pass that on. So I hope this video helped in some way about doing what you can with what you have where you are. I did talk a little bit about accounting. I know some of that terminology was probably unfamiliar if you are not in the accounting field, which is totally cool, totally okay. I just think part of living a very spiritual life is being the person who takes action and realizes that it's okay to fail. I really hope this video was super cool, super great. Hit the like button or the subscribe button if you would so wish or desire. I hope you have a great day. Honestly, it's been pretty cool for me, and I am so grateful to be able to put these videos out for you guys. So once again, thank you so much. Sending peace, love, blessings your way, and namaste.